maybe he needs a hand. We'll put a large piece of paper against this wall. We're going to do some group getting out of your seat road mapping. Hopefully I have a presentation projector in a second. So we just heard from the panel. I really enjoyed being constrained. I couldn't talk, just listening and hearing everyone's viewpoints. So thank you so much for participating in that. There we go. And now we want to actually do basically the same thing for everyone here. So we have 45 minutes. I think we're running a little behind again, but to go through, is this the right one? This is the wrong one. Let me skip ahead here. So capabilities road mapping. A side note, if you're really into MoveIt, you might note that the Move group capabilities are different than MoveIt capabilities, depending if you know what I'm talking about. But so we just want to get your feedback. Is this the only piece? Do we have that big long roll? Okay, so just a recap from this morning. We've got a lot of new features in the ecosystem that are coming online. Some of these are still pull requests that are being reviewed, but most of them have merged in. We've been presenting these today at RossCon, and more will be coming out later. To the person who asked about highest about time optimization algorithms, we have two that we've added recently, but another, we always need more. They're very mathy. Another recap is I presented this briefly this morning about our immediate three milestones are the top that we're like, that's what Picnic's really behind based on our feedback. But these bottom three are more up in the air, and we've heard today a lot of other ideas. And so the ordering is to be determined, and the exact details to be determined. So I've been reading about open source communities a bit and how to lead a successful one. And this book by Eric Raymond called The Cathedral Versus the Bazaar, he's a old school Linux open source developer, and he chronicles the history of different periods of open source. And there's, you know, he categorizes open source or software development into two categories. The cathedral, you're carefully crafted by a few individuals, it's more top down, more isolated. This would typically be a traditional tech company that has a hierarchy of leadership, and you have product managers passing down the commands, and you build out this beautiful infrastructure. And then that's contrasted with the bazaar model, which is like a chaotic marketplace, and you have whoever wants the thing adds it. And so it's really motivated by your personal needs, maybe your research, maybe your company needs a new feature. And so what goes into MoveIt is basically chaotic and babbling. And he calls it miraculously coherent, because in the end of the day, you end up getting pretty cool results, despite the noise of the crowd. But they both have pros and cons. And so I just want to frame this section of road mapping as, to date, we've been largely bazaar-based, because there's, I mean, Picnic in the past 2 years has really grown and stepped up to kind of to lead a lot of MoveIt, but we don't want to be the only group pushing it. We want this to be a collaborative effort between groups like Ross Industrial or Open Robotics, and all the partners we've worked with in the commercial space, all the universities we're working with. And so if we can find some combination, like obviously we'll always be open to your, whatever you want to work on, if it generally makes sense, you know, throw it in, that's the bazaar model. But maybe leaning in a little more into the cathedral model of having a roadmap that we can look at, and if that inspires you and if that's something you need, you know, oh, the community thinks this is what we need. That's double confirmation. It also can affect, we really like Google Summer of Code, and we can ask people to fill in needs. That's something we've been doing the past 2 years, or our internship program, those kind of things. So keep in mind, though, that we're going to ask for your pain points, and we'll come up with solutions, but all of this, it's always been the case that, like, if you really want it, please put some engineers behind it or put some money behind it. Right, there's no magical fountain of open source. It's a continuous struggle. So we have a bunch of sticky notes, which I think are in the back. I've lost Rob. I'm doomed. So I'm going to distribute sticky notes. If you were at the workshop for RossCon, the day zero, and you were in Bill Smart's workshop where he went over the Ross ecosystem and things, I'm trying to do something like that. So I talked to him about how he did it. The sticky notes are actually from him. And so I'm going to pass out sticky notes. And the context is We're going to spend the next 10 minutes, maybe on that wall, write down the problems, the limitations, and the missing requirements that you have for the MoveIt project. Thank you, Andy, for passing this out. And come up here and put it on the wall, and then the idea, I'm not really sure how to run this, but let me know if you have suggestions. But this is based on Bill Smart's model. We're going to take a quick break after we get all those things on the wall, and a couple of us are going to organize those into categories. And then from there, underneath those problems, we'd like everyone to come up with more sticky notes and pose solutions, different ways to fix that, really be constructive and think of the reality of, like, is it scope creep? Is it too difficult for MoveIt? Or, like, how are we actually going to execute that? And then I think the last 20 minutes, I want to then break up into individual groups under those categories. If you're really passionate about that area, let's get into different corners of the room and dig into, like, the priorities of, like, what are we going to tackle first and how, and come up with some concrete solutions. And if you're less familiar with the MoveIt code base, then this might be more of a, like, when it comes to the solutions, maybe you're more learning and listening, but this is really just get out of our seats and get messy and work through that. And then the very last 5 minutes of this 45-minute period that I've proposed, have someone from each group come up and talk about the conclusions and kind of highlight the big picture. And so this is somewhat similar to Ross Industrial's done a lot of these road mapping sessions, but not the same thing, because you're going to choose one group and stick with that one and not switch around and rotate. And we're really focusing on just manipulation and move it and those pieces. So any questions before we begin that? Okay, so we can just stick it directly to that wallpaper wall. Hopefully it sticks. So we have a large canvas to put it on. We don't have to put it just on that little piece of paper there. And so does everyone have sticky notes? Great, okay. Ba-boom.
Thank you.
I had said 10 minutes, and so we should be 15 minutes into this. Oh, wow. We're 2:40.
Thank you. Hey, everyone. While some of the MoveIt guys over there... Hi, everyone. We're going to make a quick announcement for a break. We're going to go on a short break now. We're kind of rearranging the schedule a little bit, just so they have time to work on that. So coffee and snacks and everything are in there if you want to venture out and check out what they have.
Hello. Okay, so we're going to break into four groups now. So, can I get everyone's attention? So at this point, we have four categories that we've sorted during the break based on the huge variety of feedback we've gotten on problems and issues and limitations. And so Ferguson, Mark, Mike Lottman, who I'm not visualizing right now, and then myself will take the four categories. So Mark presenting will be the core planning. So these are, Mark, can you explain your category based on what you see?
Anything related to improving different planning algorithms? I see collision checking, determinism, real-time, Cartesian planning, kinematics, search-based planning.
Okay. So if you're interested in that, you're going to follow him to that back corner. Does that sound good? Yeah. Okay. And so the next one is on APIs and high-level interfaces. I'm going to take this one, even though I'm not a Python fan that we noted earlier, but if you're into better Python interfaces or C++, more abstractions, less abstractions, but making it so that it fits the maybe educational space or industrial space or whatever, that discussion, we're going to take that corner back there next to the picnic sign. So follow me there after that. Mike?
Yeah, so documentation usability. So this one's pretty sprawling. Everything from, something doesn't behave in the way that I want it to behave, or might seem like it would ideally behave, to not understanding things, to things not being documented or failing silently.
And then my group will be meeting over on that corner, and we're talking about applications, industry, and specialties. So this is basically answering that question that we had earlier of what else should MoveIt do?
Or not do.
Or have low priority to eventually maybe do.
So, yeah,
join a group.
That's a big one, right? That seems like an important one. So I put that high up.
for the iron rulers. You can reorder things later. So. State from disk. Yeah, that exists in some form for OVL. They essentially start up and load a roadmap from disk. That's what I have in mind in the future. It's sort of experience. So basically, you keep observing data structure for an network and then you put the roadmap around. So that can be done. Kind of an easy thing to do. Kinematics classification. I think that might be what Robert was talking about.
So I was more like representing if this kinematic object is represented by a closed form solution, sample base, inverse kinematics, or like being able to distinguish the difference between, I guess, how IK is doing something.
Yeah, but you already, but that's like, you already have your IK solvers, right? So you kind of have already made that choice.
I'm just more at runtime because you hit based on classification.
Oh, so if you're close to singularity, you use one type of planner.
Yeah, so I guess for different cases, for different planners, you may do better in the case of Descartes. You would prefer to have a closed form for one case, but you may not need it. In other cases, you may want a different type of
data. Where possible, we should always use a closed form, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
But recognize that you can use one. Is that that's sort of the thing with you? Like recognize that you can use these ones.
Yes. This is an open source. Or if, or the other case is that if you don't have to make some of these people who are actually making it, you know, maybe all the time.
Different sort of way. Is it going to be kind of straight and over, and maybe refactor should be something way more.
The ROS 2 port, where I've been pushing is just because of limited resources. We do this straight port now so that we can make ROS 2 already is a lot of work to get to. And so that alone is a big effort. Once we get on ROS 2, we can convert people as quick as possible, but it's still pretty similar because it's still just the moving from 1.0, you know. And then after that, ROS 2 and 3 is let's break stuff, and we'll call that maybe move 3, right? Like, start iterating the major numbers. So we have sticky notes, maybe we put like concrete solutions on the bottom of basically the thread. So we can kind of write
equally, then you're kind of forcing yourself to put into kind of resolution and just list these issues. So I think it's good in production, it's nice. So,
improve plan execution? Is that what you're talking about? That?
Yeah. It's kind of
an multi-robot property.
Just Okay, so Ferguson made that for us. So he has another thing called MoveIt Python that's available today. What do we think is, that also and so I've always wanted to bring this into the mainstream. I just like this because if you want to add a feature, you have to go through layers, all the way to like 3 layers, and then finally to like OpenPL. OpenPL is like right like down here, just so far away that if you do projects that are here, I tell my people, don't use this, just do it. And the reason why I'm wondering if this is really good though is because this is an Arvis interface. I just want to see the Arvis interface also like this. Right, so that makes it really useful for
Yeah.
So Arvis links to unless you're, you know, way off board of industry. And so, like, at a point. Oh, so Gazebo chose to be no ROS, you know, and now they've had to build their own robotics middleware called Mission. They've rebuilt ROS. Now they have to maintain all of that, and they have to, like, it's like duplicate work. I don't want to build Ignition. They built their own middleware, Ignition Transport, using Kuba.
So if people are going long, we're just going to clap them off, just like normal.